just want to take this opportunity and wishing all the mothers a happy Mother's Day. And I want all the children, wherever you are, just to take this moment and give your moms a great big hug right now. I'll give you a few seconds before we open for us. Open in a word of prayer. I'm going to ask Brother Ruben just to get ready. And pray for our children. Give your moms a hug. Hallelujah.
Hear your words, O God. I pray that you will speak to our hearts this morning, O Father. May you bless us, Father God. May you be with us, Lord. Protect us and watch over us, O God. Bless the service, touch the musicians, sing the Lord Jesus. May your anointing fall down and come and touch our hearts, O God. Give you the glory, the praise, and the honor. In Jesus' mighty name, I pray. Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
You move a mountain.
Standing here only because you made.
my King. What a beautiful name it is. Nothing compares with it. What a beautiful name it is. The name of Jesus. What a beautiful name it is. What a beautiful name it is. The name of Jesus Christ, my King. What a beautiful name it is. Nothing compares to this. What a beautiful name it is. The name of Jesus. The name of Jesus.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Won't you give Jesus that type of praise? Amen. Amen. Let's sing that song. Victory is mine. Victory is mine. I told Satan to get behind, because victory today is mine. Amen. Hallelujah.
Victory is mine. Victory is mine. Victory today is mine. Well, I told Satan to get behind, 'cause victory today is mine. Yeah. Victory is mine. Victory is mine. Victory today is mine. Well, I told Satan to get behind. Oh, victory today is mine. Joy is mine. Joy is mine. Joy is mine.
Facing God. You know the problems I see, oh Lord Jesus, every day. You know the trials we are facing, oh Father. But we are so grateful and thankful, oh God, that you hold tomorrow in your hands. You know the end from the beginning, oh God. Father, as we come to the most important time of the service, as we're going to listen to your precious word now, I'll pray, Lord God, that you will use your servant as never before. Word of God, speak. Won't you pour down like rain, washing my eyes to see your glory.
Desire is that God will lead you and guide you even through the hard times and the good times. God bless you. I'd like to read a little quotation from the prophet's message taken from 1959. He preached in a tabernacle, Mother's Day. And he says, "Mother is so great. And we realize many of us, our mothers are in glory. But we thank God they loved him. You know, the first one that received you in this life is your mother. No one can touch you. And she bears you under her heart. And she is the first one to know you. The first in this life to hold you. Then when you are born, she is the one of the first hands that touched you and wipes back the tears out of your eyes. She is the first one to pet you and to love you and to coo over you in this life is your mother. We salute our mothers.
Amen.
Amen. Now I think that there is not enough honor that we could give to a mother. Mother is the first with a child, and she has a great responsibility of what the child will be. Will be based upon the way that mother starts that child on the path that it must travel. So we find even the prophet of God speaking of the responsibility that the mother will have in this life's journey. Mother has the responsibility from God to place that child on the right road. And I think that's why mothers have a little special touch. We thank God that even a prophet of God could say, mothers have a special touch. We salute all mothers that have that special touch. Amen. And the prophet also, this is a long quotation, he also speaks about many, many mothers that are backslidden, that have turned away from the word of God. And he said, I pray that God will bring you back to serve him and love him on this path of righteousness. Hallelujah. God bless you. This morning, what I would like to speak on is a message that the prophet preached in his presence. It's a beautiful thought, and we salute the prophet of God that came with many, many wonderful titles. Every title is special to the bride of Christ. And in his presence is a beautiful thought, just the thought of the title. And it is my pleasure this morning to minister on this, taking the thoughts that God inspired the messenger of this hour to minister on, based on the revealed word of God. I pray that it will be a blessing to each one of you. And my text is taken from Isaiah chapter 6, verse 1 to 8. Before I read, I'd just like to pray for every mother that's at home. We realize we are locked in, and although we are faced with this disease, that's a virus that's running around, and what I believe as a bride of Christ, we have a God that takes care. And whatever your need is at this very moment, many, many problems have come up in these times of locked in. But I believe whatever your need is this very moment, if you can just raise your hand, bow your head and say, Lord, please look at my situation. There's a need that lies. There's an unspoken request. And I believe God is more than he is a God, is a miracle working. God is able to touch. He's able to set you free. If you have a financial need, he's able to take you through. He's a miracle working Father. If you are sick, you're not well in body, believe God this moment. He said, I am the Lord that healeth all your diseases, and these signs shall follow them that believe you. This prayer is directed especially to you. And I would also like to remember every mother in prayer this moment. God bless you. Gracious God and eternal Father. Lord, you see every hand that is in need, Lord. Father, even this moment, in this time, we truly say, Lord, we are so confident that you are a God that takes care. Yes, you are a loving Father. Lord, we appreciate your goodness, your tender mercies, Lord. Lord, you have always taken care of us. And Lord, we lift your name on high. Oh God, there's no words, Lord, that could describe your vastness and your greatness and your goodness towards us. Lord, we truly love you. We ask you, Lord, to please forgive us if any way we had failed you, Lord, in our thoughts, in our ways, in our actions. Lord, before we approach you, we ask you, Lord, please, to help us and forgive us. Lord, this moment I bring every mother, Lord. Lord, I pray in the name of Jesus Christ. May you touch every mother, Lord, even on this beautiful day of Mother's Day, Lord. I pray, God, that you'd add a special touch. May you, Lord, light up that fire in that mother's heart, Lord. May she have a blessed day, Father. And may her children acknowledge the goodness, Lord, of a mother that always cared and reared them, bringing them up in the ways of Almighty God. I thank you for this answered prayer. Father, you see the name that lies beneath those hands. May you reach and touch. Bless every heart. Lord, meet with every desire, Lord. And Father, we be careful tonight to give thee all the praise, the glory, and the honor. Help me, Lord, as your servant that will minister this moment. Lord, give us hearts that will be receptive, minds that will be attentive. Lord, may there be no disturbance, although we be at home, Lord. Yes. May we be serious with you, yes, this moment, in this time that we have sacrificed, Lord, this time, Lord, for the service of Almighty God. Come, Lord, into this apartment, Lord, and bless this home, Lord. Protect this home. Keep every evil arm and danger away from us. We pray the blood of Jesus. May you cover us now. I pray and I thank you, Father, for this answered prayer in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Hallelujah. God bless you. If you have your Bibles, in the book of Isaiah, chapter 6, verse 1, it says, in the year that Uzziah died, I saw also the Lord sitting upon a throne, high and lifted up, and his train filled the temple. Above it stood the seraphims, each one having six wings. With twine he did cover his face, with twine he did cover his feet, and with twine he did fly. And one cried unto another and said, Holy, holy, holy is the Lord God of hosts. And the whole earth is full of his glory. Amen. Brother, sister, if there's ever a name that we like to give our God, like many times we have many, many names, nicknames, people would refer to a certain person in a certain way. But if we have to refer to our God, we call him Glory. Hallelujah. It's a beautiful name. We say glory, we know we're talking about our King. He's glorious, he's wonderful. And the posts of the door moved at the voice of him that cried, and the house was filled with smoke. Then said I, Woe is me, for I am undone, because I am a man of unclean lips, and I dwell in the midst of people of unclean lips. For mine eyes have seen the King, the Lord of hosts. Then flew one of the seraphims unto me, having a live coal in his hand, which he had taken with the tongs from the off the altar, and he laid it upon my mouth, and said, Lo, this has touched thy lips, and thy iniquity is taken away, and thy sin is purged. Also I heard the voice of the Lord saying, Who shall I send? Who will go for us? Then said I, Here am I, send me. Hallelujah. What a beautiful scripture. May the Lord add a blessing to his word. Even as we are blessed, you can take your seats. Now, we find always, brother, in the presence of God, man always recognizes themselves as sinners. When a man comes in the presence of God, there's no great man and big man and how educated you are. Immediately in the presence of God, it humbles you. Hallelujah. We feel pretty good sometimes in different places, but whenever we come into the presence of God, it shows us how little we are. Amen. Then we realize how little we are, and it also makes us realize how great He is. Amen. Many people wouldn't like to know how great God is. But once in the presence of God, you acknowledge the greatness and the goodness of Almighty God. Hallelujah. And the prophet of God says, it always threw a great effect upon the people that come into the presence of God. Hallelujah. It throws an effect. In other words, brother, when you come in the presence of God, it affects your life. In a very, very beautiful way, God affects you. And I would like to be affected by God. And I thank God, from the time that we ever come in His presence, we find it had an effect on the entire church, every believer, every home, every person that comes in contact, there's a vast change. So we thank God for that. The prophet says, I have seen the time in my ministry when you would see the presence of God come into such a place that would bring a person up and just reveal his life to them and call their sins all kinds of immoral acts, and it brings a holy hush amongst the people till they drop out of the prayer line before they even come up to be prayed for and run to the altar to get right with God before they come into His presence. Hallelujah. So you find the prophet of God, why he come up and he begins to tell, sister, this is your name, this is your problem, this is, he says, all kind of immoral acts, everything is revealed. And when a person sees that God is showing him, even drops off the prayer line, running to the altar to confess, Lord, forgive me. And once you ask God, immediately after confession, you come into the presence of Almighty God. And I remember once in my life, coming up on an S-bend, I saw a man's hand lying on the road, rolling actually. I stopped the vehicle, I picked the hand up. Now I'm talking about the presence of God. I picked that hand up, brother. It was not an easy thing to do. A human hand strewn out with blood running into my hands. I came up, I saw a young white boy in his mid-20s, 25, 26, 27 years of age. And an old man holding him. The young man was on a motorbike. The old man was in a vehicle. He was a man that knocked this young guy. And I heard the young man crying for his life. The hand is out. is a lot of blood. And his last words were, Lord, why me? Lord, help me. Brother, sister, let me tell you, you may be fit and well today, but you never know what your future is. You don't want to be in a situation like this young man on that roadside. He was crying and screaming for his life. And the paramedics and the doctors, they took a while to come. In that moment, the Lord, I came up there and I was standing. And I was still, and I heard a voice distinctly speak. And I heard that voice many times before in my life. It said, pray for him. But because of the situation and the crowd, I felt a bit restricted. My humanistic part kicked in. I should have just said, move away, and said, in the name of Jesus, amen. But I was restricted. And when the paramedics came and they tried to revive him, and the doctor came and certified him dead, I was weeping. And out there, the people were trying to wonder, why am I weeping? I began to cry because of my disobedience to the voice that said, pray. Now I hear the word says, he's dead. They said they cannot even load him in an ambulance. The paramedics packed the things and the doctor tested him, and the doctor was on his way out. At that moment, I saw his wife. She came back. She was there. I saw her back on that scene. I said, sister, let us pray. That moment with my heart heavy. But what I'm saying is, brother, in his presence, there's a great thing that can happen. And as we went down, brothers, sisters, a little prayer, Lord, restore this man. Give him back his life. In the name of Jesus Christ. Brother, sister, not even a long prayer. The doctor was not far off. The paramedics never even get into the van. The man started crying. He started screaming back. And I believe God heard that young man's prayer. But the thing that I want you to know this afternoon is, we realize as a human being, we could do nothing for this man that was dying. There was a doctor with a degree in science, a medical doctor, paramedics who have studied. But when it came to this young man's life, they came to a place where they failed. But in the presence of Almighty God, it caused something to happen. And the feeling out there, brothers, sisters, I am a witness. There was a brother from church, Brother Glennie Naidu, he was there. He was facing his back towards the road. The feeling, the anointing was great. And when he got up, I heard a voice speak to me. He said, don't speak to anyone. So when I heard that, I just turned and I knew, this man cannot do. This is Almighty God in action. Hallelujah! In his presence, there's power. And I began to walk. And the old man that knocked this young boy, he left the boy down because the paramedics and the doctors began to attend to him. And fortunately, his life was saved. It's a one-hour testimony, but I'll just give you this few minutes. As I walked with my vehicle, the old man came, he grabbed me from the back. Old white man, never wanted to look at me when I was standing there. But when he saw and he felt that presence of that Almighty God, the power of the resurrection life, he was a witness of the entire proceeding that happened. He came, he grabbed me from the back, hard, tight. He asked me, where are you from? I said, Richards Bay. I never spoke, but the Lord told me, don't speak. He left me and he saw I was not a guy to speak. He went his way, we departed. But my thought here is, Where man fails, God is a God of the impossible. I've seen a great thing that happened. A life that was dead came to life. Amen. This is a God we serve. Hallelujah. We know the prophet's testimony, that little child that came in there in the morning in the rains and tried to get her away in the name of Jesus Christ, in the presence of God, the child came to life. Amen. This is the power of God. Amen. In His presence, great things happen. Amen. But now we find, brother, when the first man, as soon as he has sinned and done something wrong, when he came into the presence of God, brother, immediately he couldn't stand the presence of God because sin has come in and wrong has come. He ran and he tried to hide himself, made himself some fig leaves, tried to go to the bushes in the presence of Jehovah. The prophet teaches us at that time, sin was not like how it is now. That was the first sin. Very, very first sin, that was disobedience to the word of God. Hallelujah. But you find, brother, although it was the first sin, man couldn't stand in the presence of God. What is this teaching us? When you have sin unconfessed in your life and your life, brother, you cannot come into the presence of God and worship God. Amen. And we find God had to scream out, Adam, Adam, because God had to make a way. God had to prepare. He had to slay a lamb. Something had to die. A substitute for the sin of Adam and Eve. God had to slay a lamb and apply the blood. And we find in the Garden of Eden, it was blood that was shed in the But God tried to use, he used the blood of animals, but the blood of animals could not remit sin. It only covered sin. And we realize the life lies in the blood. Therefore, God himself had to come down. His own blood had to be put in Mary. Hallelujah. Mary had nothing to do with this, only carry that seed. And when that blood was shed on Calvary, it was able to remit sin, remove our sin, placed in the sea of forgiveness. God doesn't even remember our sins. We are free this afternoon. All we need is to accept the sacrifice, Jesus Christ. Amen. So we thank God, brothers and sisters. We find Adam tried to hide. Amen. There's no way of hiding. God will find you out. The Bible says, your sins will find you out. Amen. Now we go back in Genesis 17, verse 3, if you are recording. We find the great patriarch, Abraham. When he came in the presence of God, the Bible says, Abraham fell on his face. Hallelujah. He was a man that stood in the presence of God. He served God 25 years from the time that God called him, and he was obedient to that call. The Bible says he staggered not at the promises of God. Amen. You love him this afternoon, this morning. Amen. He's a wonderful God. Here's a man coming in the presence of Almighty God. Immediately in the presence of Almighty God, he fell to his feet. Fell down on his face. He couldn't stand in the presence of God. Hallelujah. On the backside of the desert, there came Moses. When he heard the voice say, Moses, Moses, the man jerked his shoes, the prophet says. He fell on his face, knowing that he was standing on holy ground. Nothing was holy on the mountain. The mountain was not holy mountain, but there's a holy God. Amen. When you come in the presence of God, you realize the presence of God. Bible says Moses fell on his face. He could not stand. He felt the presence of God. He felt the same presence that Abraham felt. Exodus 19. God has chosen his people. Amen. The God of Abraham, Jacob, and Isaac. God has sanctified a people for his name, the children of Israel. Amen. God's people, God's elected, God's chosen people. Amen. He took them out of Egypt, took them out of bondage. Amen. And we find, brothers and sisters, gather Israel. The word of the Lord comes to Moses. And I, the Lord, I want to speak to them. And when God came on the top of Mount Sinai, and the whole mountain caught aflame, and the smoke was flying from it like a furnace, and the voice roared out, and Israel fell on their faces and said, "Let Moses speak, lest we die." Amen. Brother, some of them were moaning on the road, only God works through Moses. We want to do this. We, brother, God called him. Let me speak. When the presence of God came over Mount Sinai, the Bible says the mountain caught on fire. When that voice thundered out, brother, then people began to scream to Moses, "Moses, let God speak to you and you speak to us." Hallelujah. Always get back, stay in the order of God's word. We thank God. God has sent his word. God has sent his message. God has sent his voice. All we need to catch the voice and hearken to the voice of the prophet. Amen. So we find, brother, everything moved in the presence of God. Amen. If there was something lacking, brothers, sisters, let me tell you, in the presence of God, God fixes everything up. This afternoon, what you need is, Lord, speak to my life. Get into his presence. Amen. Luke chapter 5, verse 8. The prophet says, stubborn Peter, knows all about fishing, knows the tides, knows when the water is good, when the wind, when the GDP is right, when the pressure is right. He knows everything. But he says, "Master, we have toiled all night and we have caught nothing. But nevertheless, at thy word." Hallelujah. Brother, notice, he realized the presence of Almighty God. On that boat, the Lord told him to throw his nets down. One more time, Peter. Go launch into the deep. Brother, when you come to God, you got to get deep with God. You got to change your own way. You got to get God on board your life. Launch into the deep and throw your net out. Brother, when Peter began to pull out the multitude, brother, of fish, he realized, "Oh God, let me depart from you. I'm a sin." He realized how little and how small, and he realized, "I'm a sinful man. My nature is stubbornness." Amen. And brother, you notice today, that sickness is destroying humanity. And the Bible says stubbornness is as witchcraft. Hallelujah. Demons operate in that realm. Hallelujah. What we need to do is ask God this afternoon, "Lord, I raise my hand. Move this stubbornness out of me." Peter said, "Let thy servant depart, Lord." Hallelujah. He realized his faults. He began to confess, "Lord, I'm a sinful man. Lord, forgive me." And brother, he was handed the kingdom, keys to the kingdom. This is a God we are serving, a mighty God, a wonderful God, a God that can take. Abraham realized his wrongs, amen, in the presence of God. Moses realized his wrongs, hallelujah. Peter realized his wrongs, amen. One time there was a man named Saul of Tarsus, a great theologian, schooled under the greatest teacher in Israel by the name of Gamaliel. Amen. He knew all the ins and outs of religion. He was a Pharisee of the Pharisees. He was a Hebrew of the Hebrews. Amen. On the road to Damascus, going out persecuting the true children of God, the worshippers of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. With all his training, with all his education, knowing everything, brothers, sisters, the pillar of fire, he came into the presence of the pillar of fire and the living God. That threw him right down to his face. He was right there and he realized, amen, all his wrongs. Amen. He realized he has been fighting God. And he said, "Who art thou, Lord?" He said, "I am Jesus, whom thou persecutest." It's a fearful thing to be fighting against God. Gotta be careful. Hallelujah. The prophet said, I'd like to stop here a minute and say this. Same thing. You might have got a DD, PhD, whatever you might be. You might have went to church since you was a child. You might have done all the religious acts there is. But once in the presence of God, you will feel so little and no count. Hallelujah. Once in the presence of God, you are changed. Amen. But you need to allow. St. Paul realized that he was wrong. He fell to the ground under the influence of the power. When he looked up, he seen the very God that he had been preaching and against, and thought and knowed he had seen that he was wrong. He fell to his feet, to the ground, because he was in the presence of God. He seen that fire. Hallelujah. Sometimes we need the fire in our own lives to set a flame, to come into our life and burn every dross out. Hallelujah. We need that, brother. Sister, we need the fire of God. How many of us need the fire of God? Say amen to the word of God. And let the Lord touch you. Amen. Now we find also in the book of Revelation 1:7. John in the island of Patmos. Great saint of God. God showed him a vision. He heard the voice speaking to him. And he turned and looked to see the voice. And he saw seven golden candlesticks. And one stood in the midst of the seven golden candlesticks with hair like wool, eyes like flames of fire, like feet like pillars of brass. He was girded with a golden girdle around his belt, and he was called the Word of God. And when the great Saint John had walked with Christ, leaned upon his bosom, when he had done all these things, after John had walked with Jesus, talked with him, slept with him, ate with him. But when he seen him standing there in the glorified state, he fell as a dead man. Hallelujah. Notice, brother, John was Mary's son. Amen. He stayed with Jesus. They slept, they ate together. He was one of the apostles. Amen. But when he saw Jesus Christ in that glorified state on the island of Patmos, brother, the Bible says he fell like a dead man at his feet. We can come to church and talk and praise God and so forth. But oh, brother, when you see him coming, something will be different in your hearts. We might think we do our religious duty by going to church and pray and paying our tithes. We might think that we keep the laws of the church and recite all our creeds. But once let us get and look at him, the whole thing is changed all the way around. Yes, it's sure. Think of it. Amen. Brother, we can do all these things. It's good. Come to church, pay your tithes, do all your religious duties. But we need to come to look at him. Amen. And meet God face to face. Amen. And the prophet says, yes, it's sure. Think of it. things will change and turn around. Amen.
This great saint, great man like that, in Revelations 1, he fell as he was a dead man. After 3.5 years of fellowship with Christ, was one of the writers of the epistle, wrote behind him, ate with him at the table, slept with him in the bed, fellowship with him wherever he went. But when he turned to see him, he had no more life left in him. He fell like a dead man to the floor or the ground. Hallelujah. In the presence of God, brother, your body just comes right down because you realize how great he is. Yeah, John fell as a dead man. Even in life just left him. Hallelujah. But we thank God he never died. He came back. He wrote the book of Revelation. Amen. Isaiah 66 verse 5. As we have just read the scripture. Mighty prophet. 66 books. Same as the Bible. It has got a Genesis in it. It's got the birth of Christ. It's got the end time. It's got the book of Revelation in it. So we find, brothers and sisters, the book of Isaiah has got 66 chapters. And we know there's 66 books in the Bible. Amen. It's got the New and the Old Testament. Perfect in Revelation. Amen. Isaiah, one of the major prophets. But one day, he was leaning on the arm of this king, Uzziah. He had his eyes on the wrong thing. He was looking at a man. And he realized this was a righteous man. But he realized, brother, our focus should be on God. You might have a good preacher. You might know a good pastor. You might have a good father. But your eyes has to be on the Lord. Amen. No matter how good man is, your eye, your focus must be on God. Hallelujah. You love him? Amen. And he went into the temple. The prophet says he was a good fellow. Isaiah was a good boy. Amen. When he saw these visions, the prophet says Isaiah was a preacher. He was a minister, a holy man. But one day standing in the temple, and brother, when this vision opened up to him, and brother, he knew, when trouble sets in his life, when he saw the king out of order and the Lord struck the king and he knew this is his problem, he knew to turn as an Israelite. He knew when there's trouble, you turn to the temple. Even Jonah in the whale's belly, he turned to the tabernacle. And he remembered the word of Solomon. Anytime you trouble, you turn to the temple, God will hear your prayers. Hallelujah. He began to see in this vision. Heaven opened up. Two wings flying. Two wings covered. Two wings down coming. Showing the holiness of God. And they crying, holy, holy, holy. Is an angel that knows no sin. Angel that never sinned. Screaming out, holy, holy, holy. Hallelujah. Brothers, sisters, in the presence of God, he began to confess, woe am I, a man of unclean lips. And we all are guilty. Is that right? Are we guilty? We are guilty as guilty. Amen. But don't live that way. Confess your faults daily. Lord, have mercy. And he began to cry. The people that I'm living with, they are also of unclean lips. Amen. You know, I heard a preacher once preached. He made some good statements of minding other people's business. He says a rich man or a businessman or a busy man will never mind other people's business because he's got too much of business to look after. He said only a broke man will be minding other people's business. Amen. Made a lot of sense to me. I began to think of this preacher.
He's too busy with his business. He's busy with a lot of things. He's got no time to mind your business or mind my business. Hallelujah. He's got this little time to mind the Lord's business. Amen. It's time to come to church to serve God. It makes a lot of sense. And you'll never find, amen, a rich gossiper is always broke. Always broke. Because he's always that. Brother, when you're dealing with other people's business, you're walking out of the presence of God. I'm saying tonight, stay in the presence of Almighty God. Stay there and be blessed. Amen. And God will bless you richly. Hallelujah. Brother, the Bible says when the angel of the Lord came down, the post shook. Amen. The Bible says heaven and earth will shake. Amen. But my word can never be shaken. Amen. The mountains are going to shake. The earth is going to shake. People will run to the sea, to the mountain, to hide themselves. Everything is going to be shaken up. Amen. May God help us. And I'm saying this afternoon, like the prophet says, this man was looking at the throne and he began to scream, Oh my. Amen. I'm saying, we better start checking our lives up. Something is happening. Amen. Judgment is upon the face of the earth. Every nation is troubled on the face of the earth. May God help us tonight. Oh my. Man of unclean lips, I dwell among unclean people. Amen. And these people are unclean. Amen. Remember, brothers and sisters, such an holy man recognizes themselves as sinners in the presence of God. What will the sinner and ungodly do in that day? Amen. What will people who sit in the meetings, what will the people do that seen the power of God and heard the countdown of the word, that seen the manifestation of himself beyond the shadow of doubt, every scripture fulfilled, and still try to make it to heaven without being born again or receive the Holy Ghost? Brother, you cannot make it to heaven without being born again or receive the baptism of the Holy Ghost. You heard the message? You see the manifestation of God. You hear the word of God. You see the power. Brother Branham is asking the question, how can that be? Amen. The Bible says in 1 Peter 4:18, if the righteous man be scarcely saved, where will the sinner and ungodly appear? The righteous, brother, are scarcely saved. Where will the sinner and ungodly appear? What kind of a place are we going to stand if we see God unfold himself right before us and see the glory of God just the same as them men did? And what kind of men cried out, prophets and sages upon whom the word of God is based on? If they cried and fell to their feet and screamed, I'm a man of unclean lips, I'm unclean, what will then be for a man who won't even confess his sins? Brother, shocking. Holy men are crying, Lord, forgive us. What is going to be the plight? And he says, what will it be that a teenager who won't confess his or her sins? What will it be for the hard-hearted man that thinks he knows more about God's creation than God does himself? What will happen to that man that spent all his life trying to disprove the Bible? Where will that guy appear on that day? Fighting all his life, fighting the word of God. Teenager doesn't want to confess. Teenage girl don't want to listen. Brother, judgment is knocking on the door. Brother, this is the time to shake the people. This is the time that God said that come a time he will shake Mount Sinai one time, but there's coming a time a shaking again. Brother, I'm telling you, the whole world is shaking. If there's ever a shaking, Brother, even we, right here down in Richards Bay, people are shaking me. Police, the governments, the president, the rich, the poor, everyone is shaking. And he wouldn't only shake the mountain, he would shake everything that would be moved. Everything that's movable, God will shake it. This is what the prophet is saying. This is in 1962. But did you notice the rest of the scripture? But we have received a kingdom that cannot be moved. Hallelujah! We have received a kingdom that cannot be moved. Hallelujah! Everything that can be shook will be shaken. Heaven and earth will shake. The earth will shake. Heaven and earth will pass away. But my word shall never pass away. For upon this rock I'll build my church, and the gates of hell will never prevail against it. Everything that can be shook will be shaken. But we receive a kingdom which is the word of God himself, and God is the word. The kingdom of God is the word of God that cannot be shaken, cannot be moved. Amen. He didn't shake himself. Amen. God cannot shake himself. Amen. Oh my. But we received a kingdom that cannot be moved. It's unshakable, St. Paul, the Hebrew writer. You love the Lord? God has blessed us with a glorious evening time message. We saw the glory of God like Moses saw it. Same pillar of fire, the same power of God, the same Christ revealing himself, showing himself, keeping his word in the last days. What Paul saw, we saw in this end time. God revealing himself. How can we come by then and walk and treat it so lightly? Amen. Brother, after we see the seriousness and the sins of the world, we should not treat this message lightly. How can we walk around and hold to our creeds or our denominations and not take the word of God? What will it be for us in that day? How will it happen with us when we see the glory of God? The old proverb, in the book of Proverbs, fools will walk with hobnailed shoes where angels fear to trod. Amen. That's right. The fools have said in their heart, there is no God. When a man says there's no God, the Bible calls him a fool. Amen. When he sees God manifested so perfectly in his own word, not by creed, but by his word, and then walk right over it and make fun of it, is a fool. Brother, we are not here to make fool of the word of God or make fool of a man of God. We are here to uphold the word of life. Amen. A sinner that will repent, he knows that there's bloody sacrifice waiting to stand in his place. That's what gives him consolation. Hallelujah. Brother, when a man repents, there is blood, there is sacrifice. Listen what the prophet says. I've seen the glory of God. I felt his power. I know his touch of his hand. I know the touch of his chastisement. I know what God is. And I know I am undone. But there is one standing there for me. Amen. There is one who stands there and says, Father, lay all his iniquity upon me, because he stood for me down on earth. Hallelujah! The prophet says that. Then I have walked to the throne of God boldly, having grace in my heart, to know it's not by my good works, but by the mercy I am saved. Not what I could do, what I could join, what I could say, but it's by his grace that he has saved us. We thank God for his saving grace. How can I ever go to heaven? How could you go to heaven? We cannot do it. And no way for us to do it. But there's one who made a way and He is the way. And how do we get to Him? By one Spirit, we are baptized into one body, which will be raised up like an open. Amen. When the countdown is finished, the bride of Jesus Christ will be taken up to meet the Lord in the air. Oh, that after we have come into the presence now, we know we have been in His presence. We have seen Him do these things. Is here on earth. Amen. He did when He was here on earth. Brothers and sisters, we have seen what the Lord did when He was on earth. What He's trying to say, how do we know the vine you are looking at? Because the fruit, it bears. Amen. In other words, when you look at the true church of God, how do you know you are in the true church of God? You see it by its fruits. Amen. The prophets, how do you know that the church you are going to? By the fruit it bears. Jesus said, He that believeth on me, the works that I shall do, he shall do also. The works that I do, you shall do also. These signs shall follow them that believe. Amen. Hallelujah. Then when we come in His presence, and when a man comes once into the presence of God, he's changed forever. Hallelujah. Brother, he's not going in, coming out, going to be... No, brother, when you come once in the presence of God, you are changed forever. There's any changing to Him. Amen. If there's any changing to Him. Amen. That's what the prophet says. Now, there are those who could walk in the presence of God and pay no attention to it. He was never ordained to eternal life. There are people that will come, hear the message, day in and day out, and pay no attention to it. He wasn't ordained to life. So shocking, but it's scary, amen. But if he was predestinated of God, as soon as the first move hits, he knows it. That catches the fire. Hallelujah. Notice, the first time you feel that flame, you're in the presence of God, you are predestinated, the fire catches on. The Lord begins to fan that fire. It's a blaze. Hallelujah. Look at the woman at the well. Look at the woman. She was an ill-famed woman. Nothing good about her. But the first time she came in the presence of God, brother, she remained never the same. She went out and she began to tell me, come see a man. This is Messiah. Hallelujah. She was changed. In the presence of God, the woman of the world, she realized she never asked any questions. She right quick there. She knew her responsibility. Amen. She found the presence of God. Amen. Brother, immediately she ran. No reasoning, no fighting, nothing, brother. In the presence of God. Amen. So I believe this afternoon, brother, Peter, Moses, Abraham, St. Paul, all of them coming in the presence of God, recognize their testimony. Amen. We are sinners. Amen. And God raised them up into this vast power of the Holy Ghost. Amen. So we thank God. Amen. For what God has done. All these gallant servants of God. Amen. When a man comes in contact with God, he recognizes himself no good. How can a man walk around and brag how big he is and what he has done when he is nothing? He's nothing to begin with. Hallelujah. The prophet says, I was in Memphis in a little auditorium like a museum, and there they were watching the big statue of Hercules, big strong muscles. And there was these two young guys there, two boys. One guy's name was Jim. There was two boys standing there. And the reason they are talking, the man that's taking them on guide is saying, this big Hercules is only worth, he weighs 150 pounds. And you know how much he is worth? 84 cents.
And there was these two boys standing. And one looked at the other and said, Jim, we are not worth very much, are we? Hey, he said, no, we are not, John. Other guy said, hey, 84 cents, we worth nothing. I said, but wait a minute, boys. You've got a soul in there that's worth 10,000 worlds. That's been. You can be redeemed by the power of God if you can just let him in. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank God for the prophet of God. Isaiah confessed his sin. Hallelujah. I thank God, brothers and sisters. This body, that time it was 84 cents. Maybe now we'll say 150. Amen. Maybe with the inflation rate. But it's worth nothing. But in here, there's a soul. If we can only receive him tonight, in his presence, brother, there's fullness of joy, there's peace, there's happiness. Glory to God. I invite you tonight, this morning, to just allow God to come into your life, come into your home. You come in, go into a closet, get into the presence of God. The situation is finished. God will help you. You love him tonight? God bless you. You love him this morning? God bless you. Amen. Wherever you are, let's bow our heads. Thank the Lord this morning that God has blessed us and that God will take us through this journey. We also remember those that are not well. Every nation, we pray that God would help them. The whole world is looking for a virus cure. They are looking for a vaccine. But tonight we are not looking. We have found a vaccine. And our vaccine is the Holy Ghost. Once you are inoculated with the Holy Ghost in power, let me tell you, church, nothing is able to touch you. Hallelujah. No disease, no demon power. We need that vaccine tonight, the Holy Ghost. And if you want that in your life, you could raise your hand and say, Lord, give me this that I need now, Father. Please forgive me of my failures. Make right with God. Don't let things hold you down. Be free with God. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Gracious God and eternal Father, truly, Lord, we love you, we appreciate thee, Lord. Lord, in his presence, we realize, great men realize how little they are. Great men fell to their faces. Who are we this morning? May we, Lord, acknowledge you as our Lord, our Savior. Forgive us, Lord. Truly, Lord, this is the hour and the moment we need thee, Lord. We see the whole world is shaking. But Lord, we stand on a kingdom that cannot be moved. A kingdom that is the word of God. Bless your children, Lord. Anoint the ears of your word this morning. Bless us, Lord, this morning. Bless the mothers, Lord. Fill them with the Holy Ghost. Those that are backslidden, those that have turned away. Turn them back on, Lord, and bring them back into the house of prayer. Oh God, we love you this morning. Be with us now, we pray. Once again, we ask you, Lord, to, Lord, visit every home in this time while they have closed down churches. But, Lord, they cannot close you, Lord. Come and be the author and the finisher of our faith. We invite you into our lives, Lord, into our hearts. Come, Lord Jesus, come, sweet Jesus. Be with us now, we pray. We pronounce every sick body healed. Every depression, we bind it in the name of Jesus. Every stubbornness, we rebuke the demon. In the name of Jesus, Satan, we bind you. Father God, we pray, may you bless your Jehovah Jireh, our provider. Provide for every family. Be with us now, we pray. Lord, we thank you for answering our prayer. In Jesus' lovely name. Amen and amen. Hallelujah. I feel the touch of His hand so kind and tender. He's leading me. Hallelujah. I want God's way too. I feel the touch of His hand so kind and tender. He's leading me in paths that I can draw. I have no fear, for Jesus walks beside me.
Give myself.
take my heart, Lord. Take my life. Take my life as a living sacrifice.
My life is not my own. To you. Why? Does mommy make your mama for you? Do you like your mama? Does mommy make it tasty for you? JD, who's the bestest mom?
Mommy.
Why?
Mommy gives me a bath and make my hair so nice. And I love her. Then my hair is styled. Then mommy loves me so much.
Mm-hmm. And what else mommy does?
Gives me food and breakfast.
And who's the prettiest mommy?
Mom.
Why?
Because she loves me.
And who's your best friend?
Mommy.
And you love your mommy?
Yes.
Boy, who's your bestest friend? Why? Do you love mommy? Look at her. Do you love mommy? Okay, so all together say Happy Mother's Day.
Happy Mother's Day.
We love you, Mom.
We love you, Mommy.
My mom is special because she cooks yummy food. She makes delicious cakes. And she teaches me how to draw. I love you, Mom. And Happy Mother's Day.
I love you, Mom. You're so special to me and my sister. May God bless you and protect you. Happy Mother's Day.
A very happy Mother's Day to the best mom in the world. Mom, you are the best because you cook food for me. You play jokes on me. You love me and I love you. And you do my homework for me. I love you to the moon and back. May God richly bless you and have an awesome day from Ileana and I.
Happy Mother's Day, Mom. Welcome to our Daddy Talk.
Mother's Day, Mom. I really appreciate you because you help me in my schoolwork. And because you cook for us every day. Thank you.
And my mommy is better than I ever was. And I'm going to go there.
Hold the paper. Go.
My mom is the best.
My mom is the best.
Because I love her.
She teaches us for the Bible.
Jesus.
You are the best mom in the world. Give us my heart. I love you. God bless you.
Why I love mommy the best? Because she always teaches us about the Bible. Always pray every day and every night. Brush our teeth in the morning. Wake up, have breakfast. Go to school. When it's on lockdown, our teacher sends us some homework. My mom teaches us a lot about the Bible. I love her because she makes really nice food. She's the best of all moms. I love her so much and I love you, Mom. God bless you. May God keep you safe.
Happy Mother's Day. I love you, Mommy. May God keep you for many more years. And thank you for giving us food and yummy food every. And thank you for letting us play on the TV game. Thank you. I love you, Mom.
Happy Mother's Day. I love you. Bless you.
Happy Mother's Day. God bless you. I love you. Thank you for all the things you do.
Happy Mother's Day. I love you.
May God bless you for many more years. You're the best mom. I love you.
My mom is special because she loves me unconditionally no matter what I do. She is my teacher. She teaches me schoolwork. She teaches me how to respect and how to be obedient. Most of all, she teaches me the word of God and how to pray. We love you. Have a blessed day. Happy Mother's Day and God bless.
Dear Mom, you've given me so much love from your heart and warmth of your touch. The gift of life, and you're a friend to me. We have a very special bond which only comes from God, I'm sure you agree. As a child, I would like to say, Mom, I love you. I love you even more with each and every new year. If I could have chosen, I would have picked no other than you to be my lifelong friend and precious mother. Dear Ma, you are a guiding light in my life and a source of endless inspiration. There's no woman who has taught me as much or has loved me as deeply as you. Thank you for always believing in the best of me and encouraging me to pursue my dreams. I love you so much. Happy Mother's Day to all the beautiful moms in the church and God bless you all. Proverbs 31:28.
Happy Mother's Day. Happy Mother's Day.
Because it is your special day, we would like to stop and say a happy, happy, happy Mother's Day.
Hooray! And for the path that always leads me home, I thank you for the time you took to see the heart inside of me. Gave me the roots to start this life, and then you gave me wings to fly, and I learned to dream because you believed in me. There's no power like it on this earth, no treasury equal to its worth. Of a mother's love.